Welcome, and thanks for tuning in to the CaneCast Show, where you will get behind-the-scenes insider access to the Canes baseball family. I am your host, Rob Younce, and I will take you onto the diamond to meet current players, alumni, Canes coaches, college coaches, and pro scouts. In today's episode, we talk with Canes founder and CEO Jeff Petty and Canes general manager Dan Gitzen about what to expect on the CaneCast Show. Now, without wasting any two-strike pitches, let's get some insight into a different brand of baseball.
Hey, what's up, everybody? My name is Rob Younce, and this is the first episode of CaneCast. Want to really go into, what this show is going to be about, who we're going to be having on, and really what we're trying to do. So, you know, we put this thing together. Dan and Jeff and I had some conversations about putting together something to get information out about our kids and former players and things like that, and bring influential people in baseball together in one spot where we could talk and disseminate some information and really just talk about baseball because it's so much fun, and of course we all miss it. So got two great guys on today, Jeff Petty, the founder of the Canes, and Dan Gitzen, the general manager of the Canes. So Jeff, tell me a little bit about tell me a little bit about what you want to accomplish with this CaneCast.
Well, Dan came to me with it, and I guess you guys have been talking about doing it, and I think it's a great idea. Just, you know, bring light to everything that's going on in the program, past, current, and future. Just talk to youth coaches, high school coaches, former players, so maybe some guys that are in college baseball or pro baseball, or maybe some guys that are currently playing with us too, high school coaches. I think that when Dan came to me about it and just was telling me about what your guys' idea is, I think it's just awesome. And there's a lot of resources out there and a lot of things that, you know, that we can put out that will be a lot of fun to hear, like you said.
Yeah, I agree. And I think that's, you know, it's great to have you on. I know, you know, we're all itching for baseball,
so maybe this kind of scratches that itch. Dan, you know, what are you hoping to get out there about this CaneCast?
Well, I think, Rob, as we enter, you know, this age of technology, more and more people you can see are using social media platforms, podcasts, video, all the technology that's at our fingertips now that has really grown this game of baseball, you know, exponentially across the United States, across the world, and has brought to light, you know, the amount of players, the amount of resources, the amount of people that are doing amazing things. And we really sat down. I remember sitting down with you about this and saying, you know, there's just so much content that we can bring to our viewers about the players in our program, about the franchises under the Canes umbrella, about the guys who are playing professional baseball right now that maybe you don't know their stories, what they were doing when they're 14, 15, 16, 17 years old, how this program came to light, became a true national powerhouse. And then really what you don't see on the everyday aspect of social media, you know, you see the championships, you see the gear, you see the kids that are getting national recognition are the bones of this organization. You know, the high school coaches that we employ, the youth teams that we have, that kids will grow up from the ages of 9 all the way up to 17 years old in our uniforms. The off-season training applications such as Blast Motion, Interpro, the brand new virtual combine initiative that we've done, the development that people will say, well, just a showcase organization, the only thing that you guys are about is about getting kids scholarships and winning travel tournaments. Well, that's not it. I think that what you'll see from these podcasts is you'll start to see the integral pieces of this program and the integral people in this program that have grown to make this really a national showcase and development organization as opposed to just a showcase organization where people pay money and show up on weekends and roll the ball out. That's really what I think this aspect of the CaneCast podcast really is going to bring to light here over the next couple of months.
You know what? I think that's a great segue because a lot of people, you know, that are doing showcase now aren't doing it the way that we are. And I'm really proud to be a part of this and be consider you guys friends. You guys, you know, we've known each other for quite a while. And
I think a lot of people don't get to see what's behind the curtain. what, you know, all the things that you guys are doing and that we're doing to help kids. You know, I get calls from you guys all the time. Hey, what about this player? How can we help this guy? It's really neat to see. And a lot of people I'm hoping to bring to light to be able to see all of that. You know, Jeff, I know, you know, you're at Fredericksburg Christian. You're, you know, your high school coach. You coach our 17 national team. And you get a lot of kids that really need help. And people don't get to see what you do behind the scenes to help your players, you know. During this shutdown, what are you doing now to help your guys and to make sure that if, when we do kick off, that they're ready? I mean, what kind of things are you doing right now?
Well, I think the first thing is try to get a line in on a psychiatrist, right?
Absolutely.
No, but yeah, everybody's on edge and everybody's kind of, you know, it's mentally, I think, is the hardest part. You know, especially seniors that have lost their season for high school, and that's something they'll never get back. But just check in on guys mentally. But we've sent, as far as the high school is concerned, you know, I'm not allowed to be with them.
Yeah.
So just kind of sent them some workouts to do. I've kind of transitioned into letting them lift heavy again, because it's almost like a little off season. Right now, you know, you can lift, you know, I'm really not a fan of lifting heavy when you're playing. I like to have your guys doing some little touch-up workouts, high reps. And I even spent some time talking to Jake Cabe a little bit this off season, asking him about, you know, does he lift in season? And it's really touch and go, go in there once or twice a week and lift really light, heavy rep. And, but right now I've encouraged our guys to lift heavy because I don't know when they're going to get back on the playing field. They're just taking swings and maybe long tossing, or maybe amp back up some type of throwing program. I know that there's a lot of throwing programs out there, but just encourage them to stay in the gym and find a way to lift. I mean, some guys are having to get creative with lifting at home because obviously gyms are closed. And just stay active, and you don't know when people are going to hit the go button.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, and you touched on throwing programs. We've been very fortunate with the Canes, as you know, to be, you know, be affiliated with some of the guys that we are. Could you touch on that a little bit, Jeff? You know, if guys are out there looking for a throwing program?
Sure, yeah. I mean, Jamie Evans was one of the creators of really one of the first weighted ball programs there was with Tom House years ago. And he was coaching with us when that came to light. And then he's worked with Mike Williams some, and a lot of our guys have come through and done that program. So that's a program that we have had at kids' fingertips, you know, the ability to get that thing. We've been able to give that to kids over the years for sure. But, you know, as well as I do, the game's changing so much, and it's everybody's got a throwing program, right? I mean, these kids – we've got so many different kids from so many different areas, and they go to this pitching coach and that, you know, hitting coach and whatever. And it's hard to push up any type of a program on anybody nowadays. Cause you know, and another thing is kids do different things and different things work for different people. I mean, I was talking to Joe Manapply the other day, and he's not a big fan of the weighted balls. And he said he's really gained some velocity this off season. Joe lives on a farm with his wife. I mean, he's in the middle of nowhere, and he's bought a net, and he's got some type of program that he made for himself that's working. So it's just, there's different types of things that different work that work for different people, you know. And but I think that the weighted ball program is something that's worked for different guys, and I think having an open mind to everything that's out there is important.
Yeah, absolutely. I think that's super important. And Dan, you know, there have been a lot of things that we've added as tools in our toolbox for our players, you know, even just this year. I mean, gosh, you know, with Blast Motion, InterPro, and things like that. Could you touch on that? You know, what kind of things can our kids be doing now, or really any kids? I mean, you know, I know this is geared towards our Canes guys, but what kind of things can kids be doing now with some of the tools that we've helped provide?
Well, yeah, thanks, Rob. Real big aspect of what we put in the offseason, and I'll touch on this first. When we went to make decisions to be more encompassing to the development standpoint for our players at the high school level. We've always been really big on the development at the youth level. We've always been really big on encouraging our players to get bigger, faster, stronger, but giving them a guideline really started with the Interpro software. Eric Arante and Stephen Downing, who approached us last year, they really wanted to bring a mental and physical performance-based application to all of our players. Now, look, I'm going to tell you this right now. They're the top 1% of elite-level athletes are going to train on their own with elite-level trainers. You know, we have had Josh Wright, who works with our National 17U and National American, or in our American 17U program for the last couple of years. Josh is dealing with, more often than not, the top 1% of players. And that leaves 99% of the guys in our program who will never get to see Josh, never have the experience of getting off a bus and working with a high-level trainer like him. And in order to bring that to the different walks of our Canes baseball life, the kids who Jeff touched on, Joe Manapply lives on a farm. We got kids that, you know, live on farms, train on farms, don't have access to gyms, don't have access to, you know, 24,000 square foot Gold's gyms down the street from them, or, you know, they got, you know, their own weight and whatever they can find.
Or they might have access to a Gold's gym, but they don't know what the heck to do.
Correct. Right. And the great part of it is that Stephen Downey worked in the front office for the Los Angeles Dodgers and has access to pretty much every strength and conditioning coach in Major League Baseball. And they've started to develop programs where you can literally go in there, type in your weight, your height, what you want to get out of it, what season you're in, and what equipment you have. And you can go in and get a basic lifting program for that day based on how sore you are, what you want to get done, how much time you have to work, and the equipment around you so that you can get a workout in. I mean, let's just talk about it. Right now, most of us are in our house. And while some of us have a treadmill and maybe a couple of weights, we don't have access to all of the things that we do. With the Interpro software, right now we're going to be instituting a 60-day Interpro challenge for our guys in the Canes baseball program starting April 1st. Where the kids will get on the software. They'll go through not only their physical training parts, but their mental training parts as well for 60 days. And we'll have different benchmarks. We'll have different social media shout outs, leaderboards, and other things for that to just help promote them not to just sit around and be handcuffed by not being able to go out and go to their gym. And I think that's been really, really neat. You touched a little bit on blast motion. Blast motion obviously has been adopted by Major League Baseball as the hitting tool for the digital hitting community. It's just a really amazing device where kids can strap their blast motion sensor onto the end of their bat, take swings, get swing data such as launch angle, bat speed, hand speed. It's just amazing. Cody Wheeler has really done an amazing job as our director of player development of getting these guys onboarded. And it has evolved not only from the videos that you'll see on our social media with our hack of the day, highlighting some of the kids with really great blast motion data, to even going into now where we have launched a remote training academy so that kids that don't have access to their hitting instructor, just based on the fact that, you know, let's call it what it is, with the guidelines that's been put down, you can't have 100 kids sitting in there in a 24,000 right. square foot facility hitting baseballs all day long. You're usually relegated to one-on-one instruction, and these facilities are overbooked because they have to take safety measures. Well, now having the ability to put your blast motion data in, upload it to the app, have guys from the remote academy call you up, go over your swing data, go over your videos, do overlays, and give you tangible feedback without you having to go out into the world. I mean, it's a great opportunity. And rolling back to it, even if we had the ability to go out and do this stuff and have one-to-one contact, two-to-two contact, baseball practices, stuff like that, it's still great to just get a different opinion from time to time. Right. You know, you keep hearing the same thing over and over again, it becomes white noise. I'll tell you right now, your hitting instructor is like buying a car. It's got to fit for you. You know, it doesn't have to fit for everybody. You got to believe in it. You got to want to drive it every single day. And if that guy is in Virginia Beach and you're in Northern Virginia, why not jump on a remote training academy and have the ability to get feedback from somebody you trust? I know right now, Rob, there's probably about 30 kids right now in our organization who don't play for you that would love to hear from Rob Younce on hitting because they trust Rob Younce as a hitting instructor. This is a great opportunity to do so. And I think that the Blast Motion application has been integral in us doing this with our people.
Yeah, you know, it's been neat to watch because I think what I'm taking from it, you know, from both of you, is really how much we care and how much we're trying to provide value to all of these families that are entrusting us with their kids. So, you know, it's neat to see all of the pieces and all the tools we're giving them to be able to do that. So that's really neat. The athlete needs to go out and do it. I mean, I think that's something where Jeff, you know, you've started this, you know, years ago. What is it, on year 13 now, I think? 12, something like
2005.
That?
2005. So we're approaching 15.
Yeah. Holy cow. Yeah. So, yeah. You know, you started this and you've brought these kids, you know, went out and found the kids that were hungry. And I think we'd really do a great job of still doing that. You know, we're kind of getting to the end here, but Jeff, tell us, you know, some of the advice you'd give some of these kids that are sitting around now, you know, quarantined, eating a lot of food, taking off mom and dad. What kind of, give me two or three things that you think might help them now to prepare them. You know, if I'm a high school sophomore or a junior or something like that, you know, and I'm a Canes player that when we kick this off, you know, whenever that may be, you know, what are two or three things that you could give them, you know, that you'd push them to do?
Well, I mean, I think that's really, it's different for each kid and what they have access to. It's not a cookie cutter answer, unfortunately. But, I mean, I some of our kids have access to machines at Fredericksburg Christian, luckily. Not all of them do, but the couple of them that did, I'm like, you know, try to see velocity as much as possible, plug that thing in, and try to see some spin. Because you go 3-4 months without seeing spin, and then you get thrown in the fire in the summer, and these guys can pitch. You know, that was one thing. But obviously not everybody can see that, right? So then it's, can you find a net and just do side toss? Just swing practice. I mean, you're relegated to that because that's all you have access to. Weight training-wise, I mean, what do you have access to? One of our players' parents, it's kind of funny, ordered him a home gym. I mean, it's crazy that some people have those type of resources, right? So he's able to get his hands on some weights and go through all the workouts that we've really been doing all year. But what about the guys that don't have that stuff? I mean, you're relegated to running, staying in shape that way, squats with no weight, lunges with no weight, grab something that has some weight on it and do lunges and squats. And it's an interesting time. Pull-ups, push-ups, sit-ups. You know, you don't need weight for those type of things. Everyone's in a different situation for sure. And like we said, you know, some people, you know, don't have access to anything, but we're here. I mean, I think, and the big thing is that all these different coaches are here for their players. So I'm sure you're talking to some of your players, right? And they're reaching out to you and you're giving them advice. And then another thing is some players have really knowledgeable parents, and maybe they've got it figured out on their end and they're staying busy, and that their dad or their mother can pass something on to them. You know, it's really just a matter of staying hungry and not falling into the trap of sitting around and eating and just getting lazy, because, you know, the go button's going to, we're going to hit it soon, hopefully. And you'll be able to tell, let's say the button, we can all hit the button in a month. I mean, I hope it's sooner, but let's say we can all hit the button go in a month. But we get back out on the playing field, you're going to see plain as day. It's going to be in HD quality what these kids have been doing over the last month, 6 weeks. And it's going to show for sure.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's kind of along the lines of exactly what I thought you were going to say is, you know, you got to be doing something. You've got to be pushing. You've got to be, you know, the elite athletes, the guys that are, you know, probably already have a scholarship in hand.
they're the guys that are out there that are really pushing it and really working hard. You know, if that's the end goal of where you want to be, or, you know, improve your draft status or whatever, you know, certainly, like you said, Jeff, you've got to be out there pushing. And, you know, you don't need a big home fancy gym. You mentioned several things you can do, you know, to get into that, to get yourself into that position. You know, Dan, what would you encourage kids that are Canes players to be doing right now, in addition to kind of what Jeff said, given all those tools that we have? Where would you guide them? What would you suggest to them?
I think the biggest thing is just be prepared to play like we're going to play tomorrow. Don't get off your routine. I know we talked about, you know, a lot of the training aspects and things, but just mentally, from a preparation standpoint, if you don't get yourself mentally prepared to handle your business like you normally would, you're just not going to go about things the way that you need to go about things in order to be prepared. You know, we talk about preparing and practicing with the lights on. You know, if you prepare the way you're going to play and you practice the way you're going to play, you know, how many, you know, are you going to be ready to go when the lights turn on? You know, we are not going to have the luxury of a 20 to 30 high school game season this year for you guys to get jitters out. You know, you got to get yourself prepared. You've got to create opportunities where you're uncomfortable, however you can. And a lot of that's just going to come down to continuing to prepare yourself, continuing to prepare yourself, continuing to prepare yourself. Guys that, you know, are being recruited, I mean, have conversations, you know, get on the phone, talk to your parents, talk to your relatives, talk to your friends. Don't get out of the routine of talking to other human beings just because you can't be face to face with them. Because when you got to get on the phone and talk to a college coach, you want to be able to have had a little bit of human interaction when that happens. When you have to talk to your Canes coach and get feedback, you want to have a little bit of interaction. My biggest advice for kids is to stop text messaging. Pick up the phone and call someone. If nothing more than just for your sanity standpoint of being able to interact with other people, I know you got the headphones and you guys are all playing Xbox Live and PlayStation 4 and you guys are talking to your buddies and your friends and stuff like that, but it's different when you have to talk to an adult. You are missing out on the feedback of talking to your high school coach and having your high school coach talk at you. So maybe take this opportunity to have a little bit more, not peer-to-peer, but peer-to-parent or peer to coach interaction at this point in time, because it's something you're going to need just to get back into the regularity of having that type of relationship with an adult figure. Start doing that. And then the other part of it is just don't waste days. I mean, as a guy who doesn't play anymore, Jeff will tell you this, you'll tell these kids this, don't waste days. You know, this could, for some of you guys, be a blessing in disguise. Your season didn't start off the way that you thought it was going to end up, and you're not on the track of being an all-state or all-district performer. Well, guess what? Nobody's going to be an all-state or all-district performer. But the time and effort that you put in right now could be the make or break in how your summer season goes, you know. And hopefully we do get back on the field for high school, because I know this, you know, you guys need the reps. Your high school coaches deserve to be out on the field with you guys, and they are missing you more than anything else in the world. We all love spending time with our families, and we are really truly sitting down and appreciating the time that we don't normally have. But be ready, you know, when those lights go back on. So don't waste the time that you have now.
That's awesome. Great advice.
And play really, catch.
Play catch. Just go.
You only need two people.
That's play exactly catch. Right. Great advice, guys. You know, that's why, you know, hopefully that everybody sees and hears, you know, the care and the passion in your voices when you guys talk about all of these things. You know, that's a lot of times people don't get to see that. They typically get an email and then they see us on the weekends. We may touch in with them once or twice a week, you know, giving them feedback. I really like this format because it allows people to see a little bit kind of behind the curtains and see how much, you know, you guys, especially as the leaders here of Canes baseball, how much you guys care, how much you guys push, as much as you care for the kids, and you really work hard. And I appreciate both of you, you know, both of you as friends, Hopefully everybody else can see how much you guys care, which I think is super important. So going forward, how do we, you know, Jeff, I know you and I have talked, and Dan and I have talked, and we've all kind of talked together. You know, what are some cool things that we're going to be doing on this that people can see going forward? Dan, you can go first on that one. What were some of the things, you know, you and I have kicked around about this and what people can expect?
Well, I think two of the biggest things that I'm gonna touch on here today. Number one is bringing in the members of our Canes baseball family, and we call it Canes baseball family because we've been really particular about who we associate with. We say this all the time. It's not for everybody. It's for the right amount of people. So bringing in people from our franchises, like our Canes Southwest, whether it's Zach Sem for our Canes Southeast, whether it's Tyler Meggs, our Canes Midwest program, and Jay Hundley, or, you know, three of our amazing, amazing franchises that are doing amazing things in their regions of the world. To our Canes youth directors like Brandon Lyles, or even our Canes youth coaches who are doing amazing things at the youth levels. That's something that I'm really, really looking forward to, as well as we're really going to do some cool things with highlighting our Canes high school prospects on here through video. We've mentioned before we've done a little bit on social media with Blast Motion and with the virtual combine. And we're going to expand on that by getting this out, you know, because let's just call it what it is. While high school coaches and players are sitting home too, so are college baseball coaches. And the one thing that they never stop doing is they don't ever stop recruiting. They may have some really tough recruiting hurdles to jump over, you know, but that's not, we can't cover that right now, but we're going to keep pumping out information on our players and supporting them in that aspect, even though they can't get on the field.
Absolutely. I think that's great, Dan. I think that's amazing. And I love that you are taking the charge in this and helping our kids. Jeff, what about you? You know, you
talk to guys all the time. You've been doing this for a long time. As you can tell with the hairlines that you and I have, and some great hair here and there. But you talk to guys all the time. You talk to a lot of the pro guys. What kind of things, you know, what kind of things are we talking about this morning that people can look forward to?
Yeah, I think that there's some cool stories to be told. Just some of the players that have come through in the past, their experiences in the program, you know, when they were amateur level, what their experience has been in college or pro. And it doesn't necessarily need to be relegated to guys that are playing professional baseball either. There's been some guys that have had some great experiences with our program, and they went on to have great careers and, you know, get degrees from reputable universities, and a lot of cool stories, a lot of relationships really that are in place. It'd be cool to hear some perspectives from college coaches, pro scouts. There's even been some really great parents. I just said that. There's been some great parents that have been along the journey as well, and just kind of hear their perspective of what it was like when their kids came through the program. A lot of cool stories for sure.
Yeah, absolutely. I think, you know, those are, you know, some of the things I think people will be really excited when they hear about, you know, some of the things we're planning for here, some of the guests we're talking about bringing on, you know, given that we've been doing this for a while and the access that you have, Jeff and Dan, you know, it'll be neat to see the type of people that we have on here. Because if you think about it, you know, all our pro guys are sitting around too waiting to play. So, you know, we have a ton of guys that are in colleges that, you know, they have their unique stories, the pro guys, you know, as you mentioned. And quite honestly, you know, with you guys, with the type of talent we've had through here, you know, you guys have come into contact with a lot of really high level baseball people. So it'll be really neat to see that going forward. You know, our guest list is phenomenal. We've got some great people that are going to be joining us, but I can't think of two better guys to kick this off with than you two. I mean, you guys, you know, do so much work behind the scenes. I really want to draw attention to what you guys do, because I think it's hugely important to the success of the Canes. I don't know many people that are set up the way that we are, and I definitely don't think we have
two people that are running the show that are as qualified or as competent in what they do. And that's reflected in the product that we put out on the field and the number of kids that we have that go to school. So, you know, thank you. I appreciate you two as being friends of mine. And
appreciate you.
And I'm excited about this concept because once we started kicking this around, man, ideas just started flowing and it's really cool to feed off that energy. So, you know, any parting words for either one of you before we get out of here and let people get back to their COVID-19 lives? Dan?
Parting words first, Robbie, give me a better heads up next time and I will be the one with the hair on this broadcast. I did want to go first episode, not making you guys feel bad about that.
Appreciate it.
Hairline. I'll do my best to try to be the one, you know, link in the chain that lets you know that there are people in this organization that do have hair and it is quality hair. No, biggest parting thing is take a moment to look around, guys. You know, we always say that, you know, people have said, you know, baseball is what you do, not who you are. Coming from an organization where baseball is what we do 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year, I know that Jeff will tell you, you know, the same thing, words come out of his wife's that come out of mine is that, you know, you never have a day off. There's never a day off. You never have 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 4 weeks where your phone's not in your pocket. Take some time, you know, even while you are preparing, while you are doing the things that we've asked you to do, to look around and appreciate the people that are there for you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year that you don't get to. Because stuff like that puts it in perspective that without those people, your baseball journey can be very lonely and very short. With a great people, group of people around you, it can be as long as you want it to be because baseball and those people will always be part of your lives.
Very good advice, Dan. I appreciate that. Jeff, what about you? What parting words, pal?
No, just looking forward to this. If it has to do with baseball and enriching the game in any way, you know, I'm a fan of that. Appreciate you and everything you do. You know, you're definitely someone that'll do a great job with this. You have a lot of relationships and you definitely know how to talk and to people. And yeah, you have a lot of relationships, man. You'll be a great, this might be your newfound thing, be a good talk show host. But hey, I'm looking forward to it. I think that we can bring a lot of people together, which I'm always a fan of doing, is bringing people together, especially for a positive outcome, and looking forward to it.
Awesome. Well, we will be back. This is the first episode in the can, so let's see how this works. Make sure you like and subscribe, and give us some feedback. Let us know what you think. We will improve this from a sound quality, from video. I mean, I'm here in my office doing some work, and
I'm in my bedroom.
It's just in his bedroom. So, Dan, of course, would bring in the good office.
With muffled sound on a headphones.
Yeah. Hey, man,
We'll do better.
That's exactly right. Exactly right. Well, I appreciate you guys. Appreciate you guys for checking in with us. But if we can help you in any way, please let us know. Love you guys as Cane's family. If you're not part of the Cane's family, give us a call. We'd love to talk to you. Thanks a lot. Have a great day.
Thank you so much for tuning in today. It's been my pleasure sharing this time with you. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. It'll really help us grow. We are coming to your favorite podcast channel soon, so keep an eye out for those links in the show notes. Until then, live life like a 301 count.